How's it going, guys? My name's Wilson. For the last week and a half, I just want to say thank you all so much in helping me decide on the Absolute Travesty t-shirts. Your support really means a lot to me, and I truly appreciate all your feedback. Shout out to each and every one of you, whether you're watching from the USA, the Philippines, in Europe, wherever you might be, you guys are the best.
I'm very happy to announce the website for the merch has officially launched. You can type in wilsonsci93.com on the search engine or just click the link in the description below this video. The first two shirts I have decided on, the white and black, that reads Absolute Travesty. You can start ordering. Please let me know what you guys think and for feedback, suggestions, and other items you're interested in. Thank you all once again for being part of this amazing journey with me every step of the way and help support me so I can keep making basketball content for all of you. Now on to the video. A lot of great first overall picks turn out to be very good players, some franchise players becoming all-time greats, while a couple of them will end up being a huge bust, which happens once every couple years. Today, let's take a look at how often the first overall pick actually ends up winning Rookie of the Year. Going all the way back to the beginning of times of the NBA, the Rookie of the Year award was held in the seventh season of the league's existence, starting in the 1952-53 season, where the NBA actually had their rules with the territorial pick from 1949-65, which means teams can actually forfeit its first round pick to select any player from a 50-mile radius of his hometown arena, with the league trying to gain support from local fans, whereas for a team like OKC, you had the right to give up your pick in the 2018 draft and select Trae Young before anybody else since he played college ball at Oklahoma and grew up there, just like how the Lakers could have used their territorial rights to declare on getting Lonzo Ball before even drafting him second overall since he played for UCLA, just in case he gets selected first. Starting in the first 8 years of the award's existence, only Ray Felix in 1954 and Elgin Baylor in 1959 were the two number one picks who won the Rookie of the Year award. That's two out of the seven guys selected in the 50s. Interestingly, Will Chamberlain would have been selected number one overall in almost every NBA draft, played his college ball at Kansas, a place nowhere near an NBA team, but since the Philadelphia Warriors begged the league claiming that Will grew up in Philly, that argument gave them the right to getting Will Chamberlain, even though they had the third pick, but snatched Will before the Cincinnati Royals did, since he ended up selecting Bob Boozer. Three of the nine players selected first overall went on to win Rookie of the Year, and Oscar Robertson, where since he earned the right for the number one pick in 1960, even used their territorial pick on the Big O, not taking any chances and in case any team demanded a trade to snatch him, the territorial pick era would end in 1965. 12 of those 23 players became Hall of Famers, four winning Rookie of the Year. From the first pick selected in the 1960s decade, Oscar Robertson, Walt Benamy, and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar won Rookie of the Year, three of the 10 first picks. Not to mention the second overall picks from 1965 to 68, all won Rookie of the Year, and Hall of Famers Rick Barry, Dave Bing, Earl Monroe, and Wes Unseld, over Fred Hedzie, Kasir Russell, Jimmy Walker, and Elvin Hayes. It was absolutely insane that Unseld, who averaged 14 and 18 his first year, won the award over Hayes, who averaged 28.5 points, 17 rebounds. Unseld also shockingly won MVP that same year, robbing Willis Reed and his future teammate Hayes on two awards his rookie season. On to the 70s, most of you guys might not be familiar with some of these names. First overall pick Bob Lanier was one of the best centers of his time, Austin Caldwell of the best players in Cavs history. LaRusse Martin was as big a bust as Anthony Bennett, lasted four seasons. While Doug Collins, Bill Walton, and David Thompson were multiple time all-stars, John Lucas was just a role player, Ken Benson was a bust, Klay's pops Michael Thompson was a 14-7 guy, played mostly center. Magic's the best point guard all time. However, none of these guys won Rookie of the Year. None from the 70s. Dave Collins was the fourth pick and the best player in his draft class. Sidney Wicks and Bob McAdoo were picked second. Ernie DeGreglio third. Jamal Wilkes 11th. Alvin Adams 4th. Adrian Dantley 6th was way better than Lucas. 6th pick Walter Davis was way better than Benson. And Bird was selected 6th overall in 1978, was junior eligible, knowing he elected to remain in college for his senior year. The NBA later changed the rule requiring players to declare their intention to turn pro, where number one pick Magic Johnson would have won the award if Larry came out the year before. Onto the 80s decade, during the Bird Magic era, the big men still dominated for the most part. 7 of the 10 first overall picks were centers. Danny Manning was power forward, while Mark McGwire and James Worthy were both small forwards. None of them were guards. The Rookie of the Year winners, Hall of Fame shooting guard Daryl Griffin was the second pick. Buck Williams of the Nets was third overall, won it over Kelly Tributa. Second overall pick power forward of the San Diego Clippers, Terry Cummings, put up over 23-10. One of the most forgotten greats, easily edged out Clark Kellogg and first overall pick James Worthy. While the 7'4" Ralph Sampson snapped the 14-year streak of the previous first overall picks in failing to win Rookie of the Year, the first since Lou Alcindor, winning it unanimously, putting up 21-11. The following year, Hakeem Olajuwon would have won it 90% of the times, but third overall pick Michael Jordan edged him out, receiving 57.5 first place votes out of 78, averaged 28.6.5 rebounds, 6 assists, 2.5 steals right off the bat. Olajuwon 21-12 and nearly 3 block shots. Jordan deserved it without question. The following year, first overall pick Patrick Ewing easily won it. After him was 4th overall pick Chuck Person of the Indiana Pacers, 18 overall pick Mark Jackson of the Knicks easily won it in 88, since the Admiral had to fulfill his military duties, had to wait 2 more years to finally put on a Spurs uniform. 1st overall pick Danny Manning had no chance against 5th overall pick Mitt Richmond, and Robinson was unanimous, putting up over 24-12, 4 block shots on 53% shooting, was already a superstar, while Purvis Ellison never quite lived up to his expectations. That's 3 of the 10 number 1 picks winning Rookie of the Year in the 80s. On to the 90s, where the first 4 number 1 picks started out insanely hot, all either play center or power forward, of course. Derek Coleman of the Nets played the 4 position out of Syracuse, put up over 18-10 as a 23-year-old rookie. Grandmama Larry Johnson the year after put up 19-11 for Charlotte out of UNLV. 20-year-old Shaquille O'Neal out of LSU dominated unlike any other, averaged 23.5 points, 14 rebounds, 3.5 blocks, was an absolute freak of nature right away. And Chris Webber edged out 3rd overall pick Penny Hardaway, 53-47 votes. The other vote went to 4th overall pick Jamal Mashburn. Glenn Robinson was picked first in 94, put up nearly 22 his first year, but the 2nd and 3rd pick in Jason Kidd and Grant Hill were too good, won co-rookie of the year. The following year, the sad Golden State Warriors made a huge mistake, drafting Joe Smith out of the University of Maryland, who was solid, but wasn't as good as the other guys. 7th overall pick Damon Stoudamire easily won Rookie of the Year, averaged 19 points, 9 assists. Smith came in 3rd. The following 2 seasons, both Allen Iverson and Tim Duncan were pretty much guaranteed first overall, easily winning the award. AI put up 23.5 points, 7.5 dimes. Duncan 21-12, 2.5 blocks on 55% shooting. In 98, the terrible Clippers selected bust Michael Olamide first overall. 5th overall pick Vince Carter easily won Rookie of the Year, was an instant fan favorite, while both 1st and 2nd picks in 99, Elton Brand and Steve Francis, shared the co-Rookie of the Year honors. The 90s overall was a great era for number 1 picks. 7 of the 10 players selected first overall won the award, an incredible rate. The 3 who didn't, Joe Smith underachieved, Matt Dog was pretty good, just not as good as J. Kidd and Grant Hill, and Michael Olamide had no business being selected in the top 5, let alone being number 1, was absolutely pathetic. Now on to the 2000s. Kenyon Martin was the last number 1 pick to stay all 4 years in college. That might never happen again. While the 5th pick Mike Miller won the award over him in arguably the weakest rookie class in NBA history, 01 first overall pick Kwame Brown was an absolute travesty at all levels. Michael Jordan reportedly made him cry in Washington. Thankfully, the Lakers in 08 smartly traded him for the rookie winner in his class, 3rd overall pick Pau Gasol, nearly 7 years after the draft. Yao Ming was selected in 02, came up short against 9th overall pick Amari Stoudemire, 59 first place votes compared to 45, both put up very identical and similar numbers. The award could have went either way, while Caron Butler received the other 13 votes. In 2003, first overall pick LeBron James received 78 votes compared to Carmelo's 40. I might possibly make a video on why Melo was robbed for Rookie of the Year. Both James and Anthony put up similar numbers, but since LeBron was such a household name, it seemed like he was just gonna win the award before he even played a single NBA game. The next year, second pick Emeka Okafor won the award, while first pick Dwight Howard came in 3rd. Emeka was 3 years older and more established at that point. Fourth pick Chris Paul easily won it over first pick Andrew Bogut and Charlie Villanueva. The following year, sixth pick Brandon Roy won the award over bust Andrea Bargnani. Greg Oden never had the chance to show his full potential. Kevin Durant easily won the award. First overall pick Derrick Rose won his in a landslide. Three of the 10 number one picks in the 2000s won Rookie of the Year. LeBron and Rose went on to win MVP, while Blake Griffin, who was selected first overall, missed his entire rookie season with a knee injury, averaged 22-12 after sitting out for a full year, and took the honors over first overall pick John Wall, who would have won it if it wasn't for Blake. If Griffin put up over 20-10 had he not gotten injured, it would have been very difficult to determine whether he would edge out fourth overall pick Tariq Evans, who averaged over 25-5. On to the 2010s, Kyrie easily won the award, putting up over 18 a game. Anthony Davis did not, thanks to the sensational Damian Lillard, who earned it unanimously as the 6th overall pick. Of course, first overall bust Anthony Bennett would have won the award for shooting the most air balls as a rookie. You can make the argument he was the worst player in the entire 2013 draft class. 10th overall pick Michael Carter Williams won Rookie of the Year, shocking everybody, averaged over 16-6-6, went downhill from there. The next year, Andrew Wiggins won it as the first overall pick. Second pick, Jabari Parker tore his ACL midseason, and Joel Embiid didn't play at all. The next year, first overall pick Karl Anthony Towns easily won his. With Minnesota having back-to-back Rookie of the Years, one is arguably a superstar right now, and one hasn't improved since coming into the league. And since Ben Simmons was hurt in 2016, Malcolm Brogdon, drafted 36th overall, won the award as a 24-year-old. Most of the other rookies were one-and-dones and wasn't as established yet. Simmons won it the following year, which should have been Donovan Mitchell, selected 13th overall. And if Simmons would have played as a true rookie and didn't get hurt, since Brogdon averaged 10 a game, he would have likely won it easily. 2017 first overall pick Markelle Fultz is looking like a disaster, and 2018 first overall pick DeAndre Ayton put up very good numbers of 16-10, but was overshadowed by the sensational Luka Doncic, selected 3rd overall, and the electrifying Trae Young, picked 5th. 4 of the 9 first overall picks selected in the 2010s decade won the award. Zion can make it 5, which would be half the players if he doesn't win it next year. 4 is still a solid number. Of the 67 years where the Rookie of the Year award has taken place, not counting 2019, which is still to be determined, 22 total first overall picks have won the Rookie of the Year award. So that's almost one third, 32.8% to be exact. Basically, every 3 years, the Rookie of the Year award winner would go to the first overall pick. If it wasn't for the territorial picks in the 50s and 60s, Tommy Heinsohn, Will Chamberlain, and Jerry Lucas would have likely been selected number one. That would make a total of 25 first overall picks in 66 years winning the award. That's a 37.3% chance. I also done the math for the second pick winning Rookie of the Year. 15 of them done it, the last being Kevin Durant, selected in 07. Only 6 number 3 picks in total. 5 number 4 picks, 4 number 5 picks, and 6 outside the top 10. 30 of the players who won the award were drafted outside the top 2. If a player wasn't the first or second pick, they would have a 45% chance in winning Rookie of the Year, based on the data of NBA history, in case anybody's wondering. That means there's a 55% chance either Zion or Ja Morant will win Rookie of the Year in 2020. 33% chance for Zion, 23% for Morant, based on the historic calculations.
I hope you guys all learned something new in this video today. Who do you think will win Rookie of the Year in 2020? Will it be Zion, Ja Morant, RJ Barrett, Cam Reddish, or someone outside the top 10? Let me know in the comments below. I talk NBA comparisons, amazing storylines, NBA history, and anything basketball that will interest you. If you love the NBA, subscribe for more content, more great stuff coming soon. I love all of you. See you next time.